It isn't a week in my life if I'm not hurting.
Baby, don't move now. Baby, don't move.
My friend Megan was supposed to be here as well, but she overslept. I'm going to meet up with my friends at Starbucks because she decided to show up.
Baby, guess who decided to show up?
Baby, don't move. We gotta stand still right now.
I'm going to taste the pumpkin spice latte for
my
first day.
She's not
in bed.
8 out of 10.
We are finally done. It's 5 o'clock. And yeah, we're going home.
Megan says that my personality is really boring on camera. Right, Megan?
She's different on camera.
I don't know. I think it's because I'm speaking English. Maybe I have to be more hyped. No, like, what's up, guys?
I don't think that's the case. Because you're more comfortable on camera than I am. You're just more serious.
Okay.
You realize you're not on camera. Yeah. You are.
I just got home, but I'm a little bit in a hurry because I'm going to kickboxing. It's been a while and I'm really excited about it. So if you're wondering what I wear to kickboxing, of course my pink boxing gloves, because I just love pink and I always wanted to have pink boxing gloves. This is something you wear under your gloves, but I have to untangle it. It's been a while. These are the protections for my legs, also pink of course. So yeah, I'm going to try to hurry up a little bit because otherwise I'm going to be late. For my editor, that's me. Let's make a cool edit right now.
Hey, Bill, I'm in the mood for a switcher. I hit the function, hit the rose till I hiccup. I hit the stage and leave.
Good morning. It is Tuesday and I'm going to the library again. Afterwards, I'm going home. Then I have to change because I'm going to squash. I haven't done that in a while, so I'm excited. It's going to be 30 degrees today and this is what I'm wearing. So wish me luck.
Oh baby, baby, good at thinking out loud, but not too good at keeping promises. No, did you fool yourself enough to be proud? Oh baby, baby, good at thinking. Even though
I just got home. I wanted to go to the supermarket to just buy some drinks. However, there is a blackout. So every supermarket in my small village is closed. So I'm really disappointed. But now I'm just going to eat something. Then I have to change because I'm going to squash.
Where do I begin? I see the hate. They don't want to see me win. Bank deposits. I got more coming in. Top down. Throw the money in the wind. I don't.
Good morning, it is Wednesday and I'm going to the library again. This is my outfit for today.
I just got home and I thought I should share more about my Yosemite Step 1 journey, because I was just going through my notes and I found a reminder to myself. Okay, so this is what I wrote. 23rd of July 2020. Reminder, you want to score a blank on Yosemite Step 1. Don't regret not studying. Now you have the time. You can't make up for the lost time. Stop distracting yourself. Stop being on social media. Think of the bigger picture. Imagine yourself opening your result and seeing a blank. Knowing you worked hard to get it, you have the time now to make a change. This is your reminder. I know it sucks, but do it. Your future self will be thankful. So that is what I wrote almost 2 months ago. I can't remember writing this. So I was really happy and surprised when I found it again. I feel like everyone should write something for themselves because it will really inspire you. Just write something cliche for yourself. Nobody's going to notice it. Nobody cares. It's something for you. It really reminds me why I'm doing what I'm doing. I know it sucks to study all the time because I have to sacrifice my time now, and later on I will be so happy that I did it. I'm not going to regret the time that I'm studying right now. I'm not going to regret it. I'm only going to regret the time that I'm not studying. I know it sounds a little bit cliche, but you have to remind yourself why you're doing what you're doing. Because at some points you're not motivated. You need to have a reminder for yourself about why you started in the first place. If you saw my last vlog, you know that I bought two books. First one is The 48 Laws of Power. I bought the concise version because I just want to have a summary, because the normal version is really big and I just wanted to have a small version. And the second book is Atomic Habits. I think I said in my last vlog that I wanted to buy The Power of Habit. However, I meant to say Atomic Habit, because everyone says that The Power of Habit is not that practical and that Atomic Habit is pretty similar but more practical. Use absence to increase respect and honor. That sounds interesting. When asking for help, appeal to people's self-interest, never to hear mercy or gratitude. Funny thing is, when I was just scrolling on the internet trying to find reviews about this book, some people are claiming that people who love this book are narcissistic, antisocial, because some people are claiming that this book is pure evil. So yeah, it just sounds interesting. It's not something that I'm going to read because I want to use it, but just to know why other people are using it and how people are manipulating other people throughout history. So yeah, I just like the psychology behind it. So I'm really interested. I'm not narcissistic. I'm not antisocial. I'm just interested in this book, okay?
Good morning. It is Thursday and I'm extremely tired, but I'm going to the library again. And afterwards, I'm going shopping.
I wanna be a weekend lover. Yeah, I'ma be the best damn lover you got. I wanna mess up your covers. Never ever ask me how I've been. Remember why you have my number. You love. I'm the best thing that has ever happened to you. Here's your time to shine. Oh, show me what you can do.
Hi guys, it's Friday. I'm going to the library again. I just bought some Dunkin' Donuts coffee for the second time this week.
Every move I make, you're falling. To you.